Hello and welcome to Oregon State University's online permaculture design course. I'm Andrew Millison, and I'm one of the instructors for this 10-week journey that we'll be going on together. This journey is focused around designing a site through the lens of permaculture. And the course is constructed so that each week and each assignment in this course is a layer in the design process. We start with a very wide-angle lens and progressively zoom in to finer and finer levels of detail and complexity in assessing and designing our sites as the course goes on. I'm going to talk to you now about your role in the course as a designer. The aim is that you get into a very intimate relationship with your design site through this process in the same way that a good physician has a relationship with their patient. In the same way that a doctor will carefully diagnose and treat a patient's ailments in order to bring them to a state of vitality, we will spend a good part of this course assessing and diagnosing the conditions of our landscape and prescribing a treatment through thoughtful regenerative design. So put on your doctor's hat here as we enter into Earth Medicine School. Now, week one begins with understanding the climate and the context of your site. This has to do with the physical climate, but also the cultural, social, and economic climate and context of our design site and our region. As the doctor, we're looking at the environment that our patient is in and how environment influences the conditions on our site. In week two, we look at landform. The shape of the land has a great deal of impact on the way in which forces like water and sun move across the landscape. And as physician designers of the site, we're looking at the body type or the constitution of our site. Each piece of land has an orientation towards the sun, a steepness of slope, an underlying geology. And in this week, we'll learn about the influences of landform by observing patterns and characterizing those patterns on our design sites. The following week, we'll learn about site analysis. In the previous week, we began to observe patterns when looking at landform. In the site analysis week, we differentiate those patterns to really map out and understand what the important influences are on our sites. At this stage in the process, we're performing a diagnosis. What are the conditions and the ailments of our design site? What's really working for our site to enhance vitality? What are the major issues that need to be addressed? We'll answer these questions through mapping tools for site analysis. Finally, this next week is on design. Now, many people want to jump right into design because it's the fun and creative part. I mean, this is a design class, but the design needs to unfold naturally from a thoughtful and protracted observation and analysis process. I mean, you wouldn't expect a doctor to prescribe a treatment without doing a thorough diagnosis, right? So, we're still in the early stages of the treatment plan for our sites, but in this week, we're going to introduce the principles and methods that we use in permaculture design. So up to this point in the course so far, we've been examining our sites in the same way that any good designer might. This week, we learn the unique permaculture tools and perspectives for providing treatment. This next week, we begin to go into the specific layers of design for the various systems that we'll be developing. Now, the first two layers we'll be looking at are water and access. We assess and design for water and access first because they determine the primary flow and circulation of both water and human energy on our site. The way that water flows and people move become the circulatory patterns on which other subsequent design layers are built on top of. Water resources represent the basic vitality of our site and determine the overall potential of what we can do there. Now, we may end up shaping the land to intentionally design for storage and movement of water, changing and enhancing the patterns in which water moves above and below ground. But first, we design for the movement of water, and then human circulation, structures like roads and pathways, follow from those. After water and access, we're going to look at soils and subdivision. We will now assess what the soil types and soil conditions are on the site and begin to look at ways that subdividing the landscape into soil management areas can enhance the fertility and vitality of our design. Designing for soil fertility is like creating the digestive system of our design, where raw materials are transformed into rich soil through composting, cover cropping, many other methods. We'll look at the tools and tactics for creating abundant growth potential with soil management strategies. And at this stage in our process, analyzing and assessing soil conditions will provide a good basis when we get into plant design. Now that we've looked at our soils on the ground, we can turn our heads up to the trees. This week, we look at trees and other long-term permanent vegetation. Trees are literally the respiratory system of our planet and will give permanent respiration to our designs. Trees are a long-term element and investment on our sites, so their planning and planting happens early on in the design process. Tree placement will follow the patterns of water flow and access, and will be part of the long-term major infrastructure of our design sites. Gardens and animals are the next layer that we'll be looking at. Where trees are permanent fixtures in the landscape, annual or short-lived perennial gardens and animal systems are more ephemeral. Crops are rotated and changed. Animals are moved around the site with individuals coming and going throughout the life of the entire design system. Cycles of germination, birth, death, and setting seed happen frequently in this design layer. So this is more akin to the reproductive system, with continual cycles of procreation and propagation taking place in garden and animal systems. The next layer we will look at will be the human environment of structures and settlements. Housing and the patterns of neighborhoods, villages, towns, and cities become the bones or the skeletal system of our design. This week, we're going to look at the human environment and appropriate ways to construct that environment in the different climate zones on the planet. There are common patterns that we find across the world in villages and settlements that we will learn from to influence our design sites. The last week of the course, we'll look at energy and economy. Electrical energy systems enable us to run lighting, tools, and many other devices. Financial energy allows us to secure access to land and develop resources. The places in our system and lives where we choose to focus money and energy are places in which we can craft and direct development and growth. So in a way, energy and economy are the nervous system of our design, where resources are directed based on information and feedback. So there you have it, the outline of the course and our entire permaculture design course curriculum as a process of applying design medicine to our design sites. This curriculum covers the three primary learning goals for this course, which are, number one, identify the major local forces that need to be addressed with design. Number two, develop literacy in permaculture terms, concepts, and strategies. And number three, demonstrate competency in the permaculture design system. There's only one more thing we need to cover in this introduction, and that's about the role that you play in this process. We've identified you as the designer and also as the doctor going through the process of diagnosis and treatment on your design site. But as the designer or physician, you're really not separate from the whole thing. Especially if you're designing your own homestead, house, or land, then you are part of it. Now, I was recently speaking to a friend of mine who's a Chinese medicine doctor, and he explained how, in their inner tradition of Chinese medicine, the covenant between the patient and the doctor is that their relationship is one that serves them both. The true purpose of the doctor in that tradition is to help to align the patient with the highest potential for their life, health, and vitality, enabling them to fulfill their destiny, you might say. So your role is to enable the highest potential on your design site, both for the vitality of species and natural systems, and for the health, well-being, and prosperity of the human residents. So as the designer, you are pumping the life into the permaculture system. So you may have guessed it by now, you are the beating heart of your permaculture design system. So welcome to the class, and I wish you all the success. Thank you.